Okay, so the Christmas is coming, so you have a reindeer with a broken leg. I broke his leg in the end. Yeah. This was like, this career was pretty short. I think my mom is much happier that I do coffee than I did football, yeah. Okay, so yeah, it's like it has only one leg and it's almost unique, yeah. You have any questions? Well, the highest I ever got was 4.5 or 5. Yeah. Yes. There are a few tricks you can use for that. Because like if you come closer, like the contrast is this is lost of contrast. The line in here, this would be a lost of contrast. But the highest points you get if there is like a white and brown. Yeah. And if you're doing like a lot of elements, there is this trick when you can pour like a little bit of milk and mix it with the coffee, and there is like the brown is equal. But the thing is that if you want to use like a very dynamic patterns, it's not gonna be a good solution, because for example Rosetta with this like extra milk is not gonna work out. And I do it in competition, the swirling, because the contrast is always like more equal. If the judges see something like in here, like with the Rosetta in here, you see like there's like slight lines, so that the brown is not equal, they're gonna use it against you. It's a loss of contrast. But if you do the drop, the contrast is like equal. The brown is equal. The only difficulty will be to get the whites equal as the same. No, like that's it's much easier to get the. How you say it? It's like I'm losing the English words now. I spent too much time in Poland. If you have a double shot and the crema is like very dark, you can kind of trick judges, because they're gonna have like very very dark brown and white. So like you can get the. How you say it? I know you don't know what I mean. But they will just get the illusion that the contrast is better because of like the difference in the color. But those will be only unexperienced judges. Those experienced one, it will be pretty like in the double shot, it's much easier to see those like differences in the shades of brown. And some people just prefer a double shot because you have more coffee, especially in those big cups. You have more coffee, so when you do the first pour and you don't hit the deep spot, the white goes up. And it's much more difficult to hide it. And if you have more coffee, it's like it's easier to get the good contrast from the very beginning. But like in the final competition, a lot of competitors use single shots because of the time. Yeah, it's like it won't matter. Like the contrast will be only the matter of like how brown is equal and how white is equal. And that's the only thing in the contrast. A lot of inexperienced baristas and judges will always do the darker, lighter. And some people say like it's a bad contrast, like the bad contrast is in here, but all the other elements, it's a pretty good one. Yeah, this was like big problem in a lot of competitions. Yeah, pleasure. It's another question. Sorry. Any other question? Like if you have questions, just ask. But which one? Yeah, for which lateral? Okay, yeah. No. Like you have it in the rules that the presentation, like the only thing you have to do is you have to greet the judges, and basically you don't even have to say what you're gonna draw. You can just say time. Hi, my name is Aga, and today I'm gonna prepare for you four coffees. I'm gonna start with triple latte, and that's it. You don't have to say more. There's like in the rules you have that the presentation is not necessary. You can do it, but you don't have to do it. And you cannot be scored lower because you haven't do it. I do it because when I create patterns, I like to have the story to it. So that's why I do the presentation. And I just don't like this awkward silence. Like you have a music, but sometimes they just give you like such a sad music that just... That like it's always if you put a story to it and you just engage judges, is again, you kind of trick them that your presentation is like a little bit better and like your patterns are a little bit better because there is a story to it. It's all like, you know, manipulation between judges and competitors. But in latter, the presentation enough is like, I'm going to do this. That's it. You don't even have to say what it's going to be. Just 2-3 pullates with, and that's it. It's enough of the presentation. The presentation matters in all the other competitions, not in Cup Tasters. There is no presentation in Cup Tasters. I haven't done this one yet. Because I don't know how to slurp. Every time I slurp, I just choke. And it's like, well, probably I will one day, but maybe in 10 years from now, when my hands will be shaking too much. If you have questions, ask. If you don't have questions, like, you can do what? Yeah?
Yeah. Really, really nice contrast, obviously.
Because they did a good milk. Yeah. It's easier. It's much easier.
Sometimes with almond milk and certain crema,
yeah,
you get this weird, like, jagged edge.
Like this?
Anything you do to stop it?
Like that?
Yeah, a little bit like that. Yeah,
yeah, like, I learned that with the alternative milks, a lot of things is the brand.
Okay.
Like, different brands behave in a different way.
Are they?
Well, like, they paid for my ticket, so it's kind of they're paying me. Well, I saw in Poland, because in Poland, like, Almond Breeze doesn't exist. That's the thing. They're not in the Polish market yet. So, like, in Poland, you have different type of like vegan alternative milks, and most of them, like, this the soy milk always gives you like the big blob. That's it. It's all you can draw with that. It's like done. I'm sorry, but this happens in Poland all the time. I'm just talking about Polish milk. Oat milk is most of the time just gives you this all the time. Yeah, but it happens all the time. Some of the brands, like the rice milk, doesn't even foam. There's no even foam. There is no foam. And I believe it's the amount of proteins you have that you can create like the better texture. But this happens mostly with the gravity. Like, if you're too close to the surface and then the liquid is like just not getting enough, like deep enough, it's just gonna stay on top. It might be a little bit of the pouring technique. It's not only about the, like, the milk itself, but also if there is less foam, like, there's less proteins inside of the milk, so the foam will separate from the liquid faster, and you might be just too slow. Yeah. Like, I'm just saying that it's like, it's sometimes like if the foam and the milk just separates very fast,
yeah,
that's gonna happen.
Yeah.
That's gonna happen. Yeah, because like some of the alternative milk just separate immediately. You just have the foam and the milk and that's it. So it's gonna happen much, much faster.
Do you add more air when you're steaming almond milk?
They did exactly the same in here. Like, especially actually, I put a little bit less air.
Okay.
Yeah. With this one, like some of the oat milks, like, need more.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's more like just getting used to the milk and just have to try.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the same is with the pouring. Like, I don't do the drop in the almond milk. Like, as I said about the contrast with the extra drop and pour it, I don't do it in here because it doesn't work. I just get like much more of those problems. Like, with this milk, I just need to be like pretty much consistent all the time. And this also happens sometimes because of the coffee. Like, in Poland, like, the coffee, if the coffee is too fresh, it happens all the time.
Yeah.
It might happen because of that. So, like, there's like many different factors, but the two most important ones is the first, not enough proteins, and the second one, the milk and foam is separating too fast. Just the two that happens most of the time.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
You put cold milk in the espresso, like cold almond,
yeah, straight away. You can steam cold milk, you know that, right? Like, but yeah, I said you can. Like, if you do a French press, you can just do it.
Oh,
I did it in Seattle in 2015 in competition. I steamed milk in a French press. They almost disqualified me, but they didn't know this. It should be disqualifying then, so they just allowed it to me. It was in the United States. They were like, so much, you know. Like, And somebody told me that the year after they changed the rules. The thing is, they didn't change it. They just put more attention to that rule. Because the rule always said steamed milk, and I haven't steamed it. But they said like they changed because of you. I'm like, no, they didn't change it. They never changed it. It was you can do it, and you can get much better texture because there isn't no water inside of the milk. So you can get much better texture, but it's much more difficult to draw with the foamed milk only. It's not that well mixed, and you most of the time you tend to have more foam. So like it's much more difficult to get the contrast. Yes. Yeah, like in the competitions, basically, you don't have to do etching, but when you have signature beverage, like the signature design, the judges will look for different techniques that you used, and just adding etching is a different technique, and you can give like very nice, very good details. I just don't have the tools in here. My favorite etching is when I did the Indian in 2016. It was like so long time ago. I was young and pretty. No, only young, okay? Okay, I'm gonna show you. There's like a lot of photos in this phone. I'm just looking for the date. No, the teddy bear is like, I always make a sad teddy bear. That's why I got this. Oh, I don't have it. I don't have it in the phone here. I don't have it in this one phone, but I have it on my Instagram. There's like an Aztec Indian. So I was doing a face, not this detailed face as Umpol. It was a little bit different face. It was supposed to be an angry Indian, and it was sad in the end, of course. But somebody had to tell me how to do the face, because when I do face, most of the time it's like dot dot and. And that's it. So like somebody didn't know how to paint, they actually showed me the proportions of it, and it actually looks pretty cool. I like how the etching can give you like the final touch to the pattern, because this is super. No, this is like very bad eye. This is super nice if you're able to do the eye with the pouring, but you will never get, you know, like the expression on the face without the etching, and that's what I do. But I try to do as less as possible. Like three to six moves is the one that you want for the competition. If you're doing too long etching, first of all, you're losing the quality of foam, and that's the also big problem on the competitions. People do a bit too much etching, and the judges cannot score the foam before you serve it. And the longer the etching takes, the foam just gets like from 5 points to 2.5. So like you just few details with the etching, that's enough. Don't do too much. In competitions you can use one. Now like they changed the rules, so you can use only one color. It's difficult to choose the color that will not look like a stamp on coffee. Like most of the colors, when you use them, because you have like this is kind of like, it's like tattoos, right? You have the black and white tattoos and like the colorful ones, and if the tattoo artist use the colors like in it too sharp, it just looks like, you know, like the bubblegum sticker on skin. And a lot of those colors on coffee, they're too sharp, like the colors are like too bright, and it just doesn't look natural. So when I do the etching with colors, I mostly use only black color. Black that just, you know, underlines some like detail, and that's it. I don't try to use the green ones because it looks like radioactive, or like all yellow is like for the sun, like just the detailed colors, but not too much. And you know that the color changed the flavor? Yeah. The visual, no, like the blue color, for example, is salty. It's changed the flavor of coffee. Like it depends on the red, because the natural red is made out of an animal, and the not natural red is made out of something else. But I'm not very great fan of red. But all of them has a flavor. All of them has the flavors. Yeah, which is not a lot of people eat it. Yeah, judges don't taste it. Not anymore. They used to taste it in 2009. Yeah, because I don't know if you're that long in the competition. Before 2012, a competitor could bring their own milk and their own coffee and their own cups. So everything could be like, we were having only the final diameter. So like the cup have to be like 9 centimeters in here and the volume of 2,270. And you can bring whatever cup and you can bring whatever coffee and you can bring whatever milk. So we were like using so many different cups in the competition. And the macchiato was like, some people had like this big macchiato cups. And some people have like, you know, those small ones. So there was like so many different things. In 2008, the guy was doing a cup, was like a regular cappuccino, 150 mils. And he was just doing like the dot, which was a fish. The dot with 5 dots, and it was a fish, and he won. Because the flavor matter, like you could get 10 points for flavor of coffee. And in this one, you cannot feel the flavor of coffee, it's too big. And in the 150, you feel the flavor of coffee, and he just won. He was doing like the chocolate dots also. Yeah, it's like old school, very old school. Any other questions? Yeah?
Can you explain the hashtag?
Yeah, I can. Like it's okay, so the World Barista Champion was, it's kind of, somebody didn't understand me saying World Barista Champion. And it was like, Worst Barista Champion? And I just liked it, and I started to use it. The same was with the name of my first coffee shop. Like we called it Brisman, and everybody was like, "What's the Brisman?" And this was my business partner mom was trying to explain somebody that he's a barista, but she didn't pronounce it well, and she was like, "He's a Brisman." So that's why we called the coffee shop like that. And the Worst Barista Champion is because of that. But I keep saying that. It's kind of defines of how kind of barista, World Barista Champion I am. I don't wear a suit. I don't have a company. I don't even have a job. So I'm not doing a very good job as a World Barista Champion, right? So that's the, but I liked it. I just liked it. I have a t-shirt with that. I made it for myself. Nobody gave it to me. Okay. Yeah, like they also made it for me. And they're making a grinder. So it's like it's like a whole brand of World Barista Champion. Yeah. Any other questions? If you have like questions, requests, or whatever. I just like to take the mic off already. I'm fed up of my voice. Yeah, like it's you can. I'm an introvert, you know. I'm an introvert. No, it's fine. It's good. My pleasure. I hope that at least they said something new.
You have. There's no rules with the pitcher. We don't want to see you in heels or decaps cry for help. So
yeah. Like the funny part about the high heel is that they don't do it in this size. Like it's European 43, which is like 9.5.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that. So they don't do heels in this size. Yeah. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
pleasure.
It's my
pleasure. My pleasure. Thank you.